There have been a total of 194 reported sexual offences from January to September 30th, 2015, an unprecedented and disconcerting number. The data from the Saint Lucia Police Force has raised eyebrows and led to reiterated calls for the government to make a concerted effort to bring justice to the victims. News that a unit will be established within the Royal Saint Lucia Police Force has nevertheless been welcomed by PROSAF. However, the organization highlights a need to have highly trained and qualified professionals employed within the department.
A department that specializes in rape trauma healing would be vital on this island and in any country. Trinidad has it going on. We can learn some things from Trinidad in that way. As far as rape, they've gone a long way. They've made a lot of strides. But you know, if the people who are doing that kind of work don't really understand it, it doesn't help.
Lauren's call for trained and qualified persons comes in light of what she says is a nonchalant and victim-blaming approach from all walks of society, including police officers and social service workers.
You hear other organizations, all kinds of organizations who are supposed to help, who are police, human service workers, teachers, counselors, lawyers, doctors talk about these issues that are very sensitive issues in a mocking way, in a very flippant way. You hear people saying things like, you know, victim blaming things, all kinds of victim blaming things, wondering where the person was, wondering what the person did to deserve what happened to them. Except now that we have a lot of the children coming out and being hurt in their homes, what, they're not supposed to be at home? Isn't home supposed to be a safe environment?
Concern over the unprecedented increase in sexual assault cases in the country was recently expressed by Prime Minister Dr. Kenny Anthony, who highlighted specific concern over what he says is the daunting problem of incest in the country. For the TBS News World, I am Sarah Peter.